So what I meant today when I said if we're going to delve into this, I want you to see how much better it looked on the video here. But the more, I only had to do one thing on the video here, two or three or something. But the more important thing really for right now at your development is to be out there and to know that you can do the both swings. Mm-hmm. You can do the above the plane down swing and see it start left. And then you do the on plane down swing and see it start to the right. And you have the confidence that, yeah, you're learning to control the path of the club head as well as that face, which you did so well the last time or two I've seen you in the lessons and the range office hours. So, and again, the way I remember kind of like your dad, that it seems to me at times you've been dead on this line anyway, without even thinking about it. You know, that's another reason I thought we can go ahead and bite it off, Dave, because this may not feel too unnatural for you. But that's the good path, as opposed to this one. Okay. And then when you put the ball there, sure enough, you pulled it off nicely. Right on the money. Now see, it's there, it's under the line. As you get better and better with it, you'll actually be above the line after impact. And through the tough left shoulder is what we want. And you see how that ball started to the right more. And as you felt out there, and as you saw with the ball flights out there, sure enough, they all started to the right before you can work on that. And when I asked you to take three or four bad ones intentionally, sure enough, they started left. That's how you'll monitor at home. Now, and again, you could even monitor that at home, hitting into the net. Wouldn't you say, David? Because mm-hmm. You won't see the ball probably hit the net, but you'll kind of see the ripple, won't you? The ripple in the net.
You'll see which way the ball ricochets from.
Yeah, that's it. You'll see that. Like you saw here. If I swing hit left, you see it where it ends up on that side of the net. Swing to the right, the way we're supposed to, it ends up on the right side of the net. And of course, you'll see that here. Okay? So that is beautiful work. And then relative to the length of that swing, again, the one on our left is the first swing you made today. And I asked you where about where you thought it was, and you said, there-ish, and actually went to there, and then this was the next swing, where again, I was with, you said, Joe, I felt like that first one was a little longer maybe than others, and I said, yeah, from what your dad and I observed the last couple of times out, your swings have been a little more, you know, in this vicinity, somewhere up in there, right, David?
Yeah.
You have been right up in there, so when you did this one and went all the way back there, I thought, yeah. But sure enough, most of them were about like this. One or two of them were dead on parallel. I think the one right before this was dead on parallel to the ground. And then here's this last one. Oh yeah, you're doing the triangle swing. And that's, remember the length of the swing is only important right now for you to try and make it easier to get your good triangle through the impact area there. All right? So that's it. Again, there's nothing really super important about the exact length of the swing, just somewhere shorter than it used to be is what we're after, for the purpose of getting your arms to be more and more extended in that good triangle through there, right there. All right? Good work there. Any other thoughts or questions? Oh yeah, your dad said your grip looks a little funky.
Yeah.
And I agreed with him as we were walking back. So just get on that club, that 9-iron, whatever it is, that good form grip on it.
First, the over thumb?
Yes. Okay. Your left thumb should be inside your right hand. It'll fit right there.
Okay.
Right in that little crease.
You're actually kind of, both hands are going now.
Yeah, and that's where I noticed, yeah, where her left thumb got outside her right hand.
Oh, wow.
See what I mean? That's what I remember. I just started gripping here just a little bit.
Yeah.
That's what I was seeing, that she had overcorrected where
earlier this year, you were like this.
Yes.
You've now actually come,
yeah,
not quite that far, but more like this,
right,
than somewhere in between.
Yeah, right on the training grip, and then one of the things is that left thumb will be inside your right hand. You don't want it out there. It's outside the right hand. All right.
Hi, this is Joel. I'm here at Dr. Todd Elworth's office. He's one of the best chiropractors in the region. He's a TPI certified golf fitness professional, and I really want you to know about him because he can help you a lot with your golf fitness, just as he's helped my young student Taylor here in the last year or so.
And how we met, Taylor came into my office with back pain. We basically, what we took him through is numerous screens to find out why he had the back pain. I don't only treat back pain, but my second goal is to find out exactly why he has this problem. So we analyzed him, we find out he has some certain weaknesses, we put him on some strengthening exercises, and he's doing very well.
He's done great. He's had very little back pain, and that's mainly because he injured himself working too hard at the golf course. So he's done his exercises, he's felt great. I'm very, very thankful that Todd's been able to help Taylor in this great way. And I want him to help you too if you have any questions at all about your golf fitness.
Thank you.
Thank you.
This is Joel Suggs. I sure enjoyed meeting you down at the Cincinnati Golf Show this weekend and showing you your swing on the 2D equipment that I have. And so I want to take about 2 or 3 minutes to just show you around MetaLink. This is the studio I use in the winter for all my students. You see there's the down-the-line camera angle for our 2D equipment. And then we have the face-on camera angle also. And then what we also have here is 3D equipment to where I can show you your swing from 6 different camera angles with this 3D equipment. And we can get your swing from down to the 1/120th of a second in terms of exactly what your hips, shoulders, and hands are doing in the swing. And then also, I have the most realistic hitting curve I've ever seen from puttersedge.com. So when you hit your full shot, it feels as realistic as possible. And then I have 3 different green speeds for you to practice your putting. 9.5 on the stem meter, 10.5 on the stem meter, and 12.5 on the stem meter. That's benefited my students tremendously. And then also I have a lot of learning aids like this smart stick. You can see the rest of those learning aids over here in my bag that we can work on to help you learn the certain fields in the golf swing that you and I both want. And then also I help my students a lot with their equipment through the winter. This is a frequency analyzer where we twang your club and it gives us a reading here. And then also we plot your whole set, each club, on these lines to see if the set is really matched or not. Quite often they aren't, and it helps my students tremendously when they find out what clubs are the offending clubs. Then if we get tired of being indoors and we want to go outdoors and hit some, we can do that. It's my daughter! Ellie! Good to see you! I haven't seen her in weeks! No wonder you've been gone, Ellie. You've been out here playing in the snow all this time. But this is our natural turf area. This is closed until April, as you can see. But it's a fantastic area where we can step outside and hit some balls and get some real ball flight. Or, if we get pretty satisfied and things are looking better on the video here, we're kind of cooped up inside and want to go outside, we can step on out and hit balls and see real ball flight for about 5 or 10 or 15 minutes, however long you and I can stand the cold, out into the air, and we see them land at these different flags. I have a yardage book for this driving range. It's the first one I've ever seen in my life where we know exactly what it is with the front, back, and middle of each screen. And again, the covered area here is heated, so we stay out there for about 5, 10, 15 minutes, like I said, and it enables us to see some ball flight. And then we get satisfied that things are looking the way we want, and we come back inside, take off our coat, and look again at the video equipment to see how your swing's looking, to make sure that you understand it. And then notice too, my exercise ball up top here, and then also, so I help my students a lot with their fitness through the winter, and then I will help you also with your sports psychology, with your golf psychology from the golfpsych.com people down in Texas. That's helped my students tremendously a lot over the years too. So again, I sure enjoyed meeting you down at the Cincinnati Golf Show this weekend. I look forward to seeing you again out here this summer at MetaLink, or even right now in the winter. I have a lot of people that work on their games with me right through the winter. Check out more information about the things I do to help you at joelsud.com. Take care.